A total of 1,553 troops from countries like Uganda, Rwanda, Burundi, South Sudan, Kenya, Tanzania and Congo are in the country to train as the East Africa Standby Force. The joint force shall train from the jungles of Jinja, Mayuge and Buikwe districts. According to General Nabasa, the exercise director, the key roles of the training are to plan and develop a unified East African force that shall see the promotion of peace, security and stability within the region through fighting terrorism, piracy and countering disasters.
Our new member, the Democratic Republic of Congo, is expected to deploy observers for the exercise. The theme for this field training exercise is promoting peace, security and stability towards the East African community integration, focusing on four thematic areas which include peace support operations, counter-terrorism, counter-piracy and disaster management.
The Deputy Commander of UPDF, Lieutenant General Peter Ereru, says the Joint Standby Force shall counter any threats to its member states and help the East African community protect their resources.
So for us in this world, the only thing we have to do is to prepare for war. Because it's going to be around with us until he comes back to bring peace. The best thing we can do in this world, as the inhabitants of this world, is to prepare for war. That is why this exercise is very important for us in the East African community. Because if we don't do that, some people are going to swallow us.
Professor Gaspard Banyakimbona, who represented the East African Community Secretary General, exonerated the need for a joint training exercise, which he said is to build capacity and capabilities of the East African Standby Force to counter any threats in the region.
It must be mentioned here that the East African Defense Forces have gone beyond exercises and are operating together in several missions, such as in the African Union Transition Mission in Somalia. And consequently, the objectives of this field training exercise, Ushirikiano Imara, that you are officiating at today, include, among others, to enhance interoperability between the EAC partner states' defense force.
Vincent Sempija, the Uganda defense minister, commended all participating states for embracing the exercise, thereby asking men in uniform to participate wholeheartedly so as to gain required skills that shall see the East African region secure.
If you want peace, you have to prepare for war. So I therefore argue all participants from the partner states forces to take away as much lessons as possible from this joint exercise so as to enhance and harmonize our regional efforts in the prevention and the combating of conflict and other crises.
The third Deputy Prime Minister, Lukia Nakadama, flagged off the exercise by handing over the East African flag to the mission leader, Honorable Lydia Wanyoto. Nakadama asked the East African countries to continue training jointly so as to shield them from any enemies.
This year's 12th joint field training exercise, therefore, provides the East African partner states an opportunity to build synergies and cooperation between our armed forces, in addition to consolidating the East African integration agenda. The thematic areas for which the partner armed forces are training on, such as peace, support operations, counter-terrorism, counter-piracy, and disaster management.
Story by Ivan Lubega for the news.